Hi, Dennis.
Hey, Renee.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Well, I'm doing good, but I came across this blog post from the Center on Budget and Policy Priorities, and I found it rather alarming.
Actually, this documentation, factual documentation, says that we as a country are reducing our non-defense appropriations, anything that's not military, to what is becoming a record low versus our gross domestic product. And what that means, it's approaching, you know, only 3% that we're actually spending on things for law enforcement, for veterans' medical issues, for public education, for health care for low-income people, to help build bridges and roads that are crumbling in our country. And you know what's even worse about that, Renee? There's a proposal to cut another $30 billion. Even without those cuts, we're going to get to the lowest level that we've been recording, and now we're going to cut another $30 billion. That's what people are wanting to do in Washington.
Could you explain to me what non-defense appropriations means?
All kinds of services. It's for
things. I know you mentioned a few things, but
yes. Certainly, like, again, like, you know, law enforcement, our police, supporting our police and our law enforcement. And, you know, what we say in military spending, non-defense, is those veterans that come back with medical issues, they're over on the non-defense side. So we're actually cutting the veterans with health care needs. Mm. And then we're cutting health care for low-income people, like people with disabilities and other low-income populations, our school children. You know, that's what is non-discretionary. That's what is, non-defense appropriations. But you know what we're not cutting? Defense appropriations. In fact,
of course not.
The United States has the highest military budget in the world. Mm-hmm. And if you look at the rankings of the countries of the world, the United States is number one. But not only are they number one, they are way ahead. If you took the total of the next seven highest spending countries, added those all up, it still would be less than the United States alone spends on military spending.
It looks to me that it's going to affect the programs that we need here in our country.
Oh, it absolutely does. And those other high-spending military countries, none of those are threatening to invade the United States or even engage in military ways with the United States. You know, there comes a point where maybe we don't have to spend quite as much. I mean, we can still be number one in the world in military spending and knock off about 10% of that and shift it over to these non-defense appropriations.
But what can your average person do, particularly people with disabilities, to make sure that these cuts don't take place?
So two things to think about, Renee. Uh-huh. The congressman now contact and say, you know, this cut from these non-defense appropriations, I don't want it. You know, you don't have to do it. Don't change what you agreed to in the past. Don't cut $30 billion. That's one message.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next thing is pay attention to what's going on in the state of Texas, because the same sorts of thing is going to happen. And then you'll make that same ask.
Right.
And it does work. And people with disabilities can be a very persuasive, powerful voice.
Oh, absolutely. I'm glad we found out about this with enough time, because we still have time to do something.
We do.
We still have time to vote. We still have time to write our congressman and
right.
have an effect the legislature.